have. But I'm not going to do that today.
You're not?
No, I'm not. Quark's just using the cleansing ritual to increase his profits at our expense.
Yeah,
it isn't fair. And we're not going to take it.
Since when?
Since right now.
So what are we going to do about it?
We're going to fight back in the only way we can. We're going to form a
what?
We're going to form a union.
I hope we get that much applause. I guess we all know where this talk is going right now. I'm Emily Barnett. I'm president of ACT-UAW Local 7902. That is the union local that represents the adjuncts at NYU and the part-time faculty at New School. Same thing, it's just semantics. And full disclosure, I'm actually not aware of any cleansing rituals that, you know, that adjuncts have been forced to participate in yet. So ACT-UAW, ACT stands for Adjuncts Come Together or Academics Come Together, UAW, United Auto Workers. We're proud to be part of the United Auto Workers because of their progressive history and the solid support that they've given us. We've achieved two groundbreaking contracts at NYU and the New School. I teach at the New School as part-time faculty. I'm an artist. I do painting, printmaking, collage, and more recently, installation. And I've always been involved in the two worlds of art and activism. My activism actually started in high school, interestingly enough, since we're in high school today. Some of you who may be closer to my age may remember the air raid drills that we used to have to leave our classroom and go into the hall. And the purpose of these air raid drills was so that we could possibly survive a nuclear attack. So this made nuclear war something that was no longer unthinkable. And in protest, I decided not to leave my classroom. And I was suspended by the principal. I was actually literally pushed out of the building by my principal. When I returned a few days later, some students and myself who were like-minded decided to wear black armbands as a protest when we went out on the air raid drills. So that was my early activism. I continued in various ways, but I also started becoming involved in art. And I started teaching as an adjunct. I have a question. How many people in the audience have ever taught as an adjunct? Oh, wow. I was imagining asking that question. I thought there'd be a scattering of hands, but there's quite a lot. So, you know, many of you have first-hand experience of the challenges and the exploitation that comes with being an adjunct. And I'm pretty sure that the rest of you have a pretty good idea of it because there has been a lot of media coverage in the last few years about that. So I don't want to stand here and give you a lot of statistics about how crappy it is. It's crappy in the school you're teaching in, but it's multiplied because you're often teaching in multiple schools. Let me tell you what we've achieved at NYU in the New School. Before collective bargaining at NYU, the pay rates were abysmally low, and there was no health benefits, no pension benefits, no fair resolution of dispute. After collective bargaining, the pay rates went up approximately 30% and actually doubled for the lowest tier of work of faculty, of adjuncts. And currently, We have health and pension benefits, professional development fund, and a fair grievance process. And we have had 11 arbitrations with NYU. The union has won every single one of them. At New School, the situation was very similar. After collective bargaining, we now have guaranteed annual raises. We have health and pension benefits. We have job security provisions. We have childcare leave. We have part-time faculty involvement in curriculum planning. And we also have cancellation fees if your course gets canceled for low enrollment. So things have gotten better. Are they perfect? Not by a long shot, but every time we go in and bargain a new contract, we're there to make things even better. So not surprisingly, at both universities, there was pushback from the university about having unions come in. And in particular, I would like to mention the New School, which trumpets its progressivism to the world. New School took us to court, and it was quite a lengthy process. Obviously, we prevailed in both universities. And you might think that they would have gotten the message, but right now, there are two major struggles going on at these schools. At NYU, the adjuncts at the NYU School of Engineering, which used to be called Polytechnic and now is called the Tandon School of Engineering, are being shut out of that adjunct contract that I've just been talking about. The NYU administration is not letting them in. And so they came to us, and some of them came to us and said, hey, how come we're not getting any of the health benefits, pension benefits, raises, et cetera? So we're working alongside of them to make sure that they do become part of the union. And just this past Monday, we filed at the National Labor Relations Board, filed a petition for an election. At the New School, the student employees, SENS UAW, are trying also to get unionized, and they are involved. Also, the New School is doing the same thing. They're pushing back. We said to President Van Zandt, this is your opportunity to be a progressive president of what you tout as a progressive institution, but so far he has refused to do so. And so we're fortunate, I'm fortunate, to have Zoe Carey here with us today, who's a member of SENS UAW, to tell you more about what's going on in that struggle. Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm Zoe Carey. I am a PhD student at the New School. I'm also a research assistant, a teaching assistant. I'm an adjunct at another university in the city, and I have an administrative position as well. It's a lot of work to juggle this many jobs while trying to also progress with my studies, but the reality is that that's pretty normal for grad students these days. As tuition and the cost of living soar, students can either take out loans and go deeper into debt, or they can seek employment. And the reality of higher education today is that students are workers. Graduate student workers provide an essential service to the university. We teach courses that are part of the undergraduate core curriculum. We do research in support of faculty projects, and we provide a large portion of the contact hours undergraduates have with instructors. Despite this important work, we have no health benefits, we have no tuition remission, we have no job security, and many of us don't even make a living wage. The New School claims that we are not workers. They claim that we are students, and the payment that we receive for the teaching, the grading, the tutoring, and the research are just forms of financial aid. This position is in keeping with a flawed decision from the Bush-era National Labor Relations Board that denies students at private universities recognition as workers. Last fall, a group of students at the new school came together to form SENS UAW, and with a mandate of 75% support from eligible student workers, we asked the new school administration to uphold this progressive legacy that the university claims and voluntarily recognize us. At the same time, we also filed a petition at the National Labor Relations Board to seek recognition in that route. 11 months have passed, and the new school continues to waste money on lawyers and logos and litigation instead of recognizing us and providing a living wage to their students and to their employees. So it's a big issue. Thanks.
Thank you for that talk. One thing I'm wondering about is, you know, the adjunct crisis used to not be well known. I mean, I certainly didn't know about it when I enrolled in a PhD program in 2006. Has the publicity surrounding it in mainstream publications improved the prospects for adjuncts at all?
I hope so. I don't have any statistics on it, but certainly there's an upsurge in adjuncts trying to get unionized across the country, and also graduate students trying to get unionized. So I think that's been carried by news media. Mm-hmm.
And also, you know, this is a topic that's talked a lot, you know, within the confines of higher education. Like, the Chronicle runs a story about this issue practically every day. Mm-hmm. But do you think, you know, that most Americans are aware of this situation? And if not, like, how do you get the average person more involved?
I'm going to ponder that. we're just trying to get the information out in a lot of ways. You know, the campaign that we're doing at NYU School of Engineering right now, we're getting the message out to students. They have been really supporting us and signing tons of petitions in support of those adjuncts. And I'm sure their parents are going to find out about it as well. And soon that campaign is going to become even more public. So that's one of the ways we'll do it.
I don't think I have further questions, so best of luck.
Thank you.